Hey, I'm Scott Monty.
Hi, this is Chris Brogan.
Hi, I'm Darren Rouse.
I'm Steve Rebell.
Hi, I'm Mari Smith, and you're watching Social Media Examiner TV.
Michael Stelzner here from Social Media Examiner, and I am joined today by Darren Rouse, who is the founder of ProBlogger.net and the co-author of the best-selling book, ProBlogger. Darren, how are you doing today?
I'm really great, actually.
Excellent. Yeah. Very good to have you today. So talk to me about how you went from digital photography blogs to having one of the top 40 blogs in the world that actually teaches others how to blog. What's the story behind that?
Yeah, I got into blogging in 2002 just as a personal blog, and I kind of accidentally started this digital photography blog one day, which began to earn me a bit of an income. I then extended that into ProBlogger because no one else was writing about how to make money from blogging, and I wanted to learn about it myself because I was just starting to make a little bit of money off this photography blog. And it was really interesting to see how many other people started to read that blog. I was really writing it for myself, journaling what I was learning and wanting to connect with others. So started ProBlogger.net, and that then enabled me to launch another couple of blogs. And I guess that's one of the things I learned, is that once you've built a bit of a profile in this space, it enables you to springboard into other spaces as well.
So going back to your first photography blog, you said you were making a little bit of money. How were you making money on that?
So that site was really camera reviews and looking at what other people were writing about cameras and aggregating that. And I began to experiment with Amazon's affiliate program. So when people click through to Amazon, you earn a small percentage commission. Right. And also AdSense, Google's ad network. And I did it really badly at first, but earned, you know, a few dollars a day, which sort of gave me enough encouragement to keep at it.
When you first launched ProBlogger, was it immediately a success, or did it take some work? What were your beginning experiences?
It always takes a lot of work, but it was something that I immediately saw some resonance with people. So people immediately said, you know, I'm doing this too. I didn't know anyone else was doing it. And so people became aware of it and became involved really and shared what they were learning. And yeah, it was something that I think was a bit of a no-brainer in some ways, that people were going to make money off this space.
At what point did it hit an inflection point, if it ever did? Was there a point where things all of a sudden just took off, or was it just steady growth?
The day that I revealed that I was earning six figures blogging, over $100,000 a year, that was the day it took off.
Really?
I revealed that in an interview that I was doing on another site, and just...
Was it intentional?
It's sort of just a passing comment. She snuck it by me almost, and yeah. I did that, and it got picked up on a couple of massive sites, and that day it ramped up.
So ProBlogger is really a great site for anybody who wants to learn how to blog, especially those who want to learn how to make money off of blogging. Mm-hmm. And I think one of the things you talk about is how to actually make a full-time income as a blogger. What are some of the tips you want to give to folks that are out there that are maybe thinking about just getting started with blogging? What are some of the first things they should consider, other than for sure checking out ProBlogger.net?
Yeah, I think the first thing you need to do is have the right mindset. You are not going to make a lot of money quickly in this space. Some people do, but they're in the vast minority. So you want to be doing it for love, for passion. You choose a topic that you have an interest in, because you're going to be blogging for a couple of years before it gets to a point where you're making some money off it. And a lot of people kind of get to 3 months and they're not making a lot of money, they give up. So have a long-term mindset, pick a topic that you're interested in, that you have some authority in and, something to say about. And then it's all about producing as useful content as you can. If you're enhancing someone's life in some way with what you're writing, whether that be by making them laugh or giving them good information on a product that they might be thinking about buying, if you're helping someone in some way, solving a problem, meeting a need, meeting some unfulfilled desire that they have, they'll come back and they'll bring someone else with you. So it's all about usefulness.
Talk about writing, and do you have to really be a professional writer? I mean, do you have a background in writing?
Not at all.
No?
Not at all. I had an interest in communication
and
in building communities, and that was kind of a bit of a no-brainer in terms of getting into this space. But a lot of bloggers who are very successful don't have any qualifications at all in the space.
So is today, media seems to go beyond just the written word. Mm-hmm. How are bloggers starting to now get involved with audio and video? Any thoughts on that?
Yeah, what we're seeing now is a lot of the top blogs not really looking that much like blogs. They're almost portals of different types of information. So it might pull in their Twitter, might pull in their YouTube clips that they're making, some audio that they're doing, and presenting it all in a bit of a mashup.
Right.
And that's where a lot of the top blogs are going. And I find the more ways that you express yourself, the more opportunity you have to connect with different types of personalities.
Sure, some people appeal to the video, some people want the rich content that they can
see. The day I posted video for the first time, this whole new audience sort of came out of lurking. They'd been reading, but they'd never felt compelled to comment. But I did it in video, and it just seemed to touch something different in them.
You also connected with them now at a visual level,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, and they heard the voice, they saw the face, and suddenly they felt connected. So yeah, it really enhanced the blog a lot.
What kind of articles seem to be most resonating with your audience, and what kinds of articles should new bloggers be focusing on in their blogs?
Yeah, it varies from blog to blog, but one of the formats that a lot of bloggers have success with is lists. You know,
Top 10
ways to do this. Anything that you can break down a complex process or something that someone wants to learn, it really always connects well, particularly if it's actually useful.
Now, why is that?
I think the web, people like to scan.
Right.
They don't like to read in detail, so they scan through an article, and if they can see 10 points, often that they've read it and they get the message there. Other times that will draw them deeper into the article. So a lot of it's about the format that you're writing in. But anything how-to,
right,
I find really useful, and that's the style that I blog in.
When did you first get started with Twitter?
Probably about 18 months ago.
Really? So you've got a great following on Twitter, and you even founded a new website called TwitTip, right? Mm. So give some, first of all, what brought you into Twitter, and what's your opinion about Twitter?
I was incredibly skeptical of it. I saw bloggers wasting a lot of time in it, or what I perceived to be wasting time.
Yeah.
And I was a bit skeptical about spending so much time building up someone else's site.
Right.
You know, I don't own my account on Twitter. Twitter could shut it off like that.
Good point.
So I was a bit suspicious of it. But I saw so many bloggers getting into it that I just thought, well, maybe I should get involved before I critique it too much. And immediately was just drawn into what was going on there, and saw that it could benefit my blogs particularly.
So give me the connection between Twitter and blogging, and what is that connection, and how could that be used to help bloggers maybe better engage an audience?
There's a number of things. I use Twitter to research the things that I'm writing. So if I've got an idea, I'll often test it on Twitter and see
and
if
people
it
actually respond, or they won't
within
respond.
Within minutes, I'll get people saying, no, that's wrong.
Yeah.
Or, yeah, I'd never thought of that. And that gives me the signal to write an article on it. It's also great for seeding content into the social space. Every new post on my blog gets tweeted automatically, and then that gets retweeted by other people, and sometimes that will then get passed on to Facebook or a site like Dig or StumbleUpon, or these social bookmarking sites, and things can go viral simply by tweeting one thing, and then letting other people pass it on. So it's a great seeding.
So would you recommend a new blogger to also have like an integrated approach with Twitter?
Yeah, I generally would suggest that you have a Twitter account for each blog that you have.
Okay.
And I have a Facebook page as well, so a fan page. Again, it's about having multiple places that your brand of your blog is, to reinforce what's going on your blog.
Now, with your Twitter account, you chose not to have your name, but actually to have your brand, ProBlogger.
Yeah.
What was the thought? Was that intentional?
Not really. I think I just reserved ProBlogger because I didn't want anyone else to have it at first.
Right.
It was a bit of a defensive move, if anything. But I think it's been really good for reinforcing what I'm doing on my home base, which is my blog.
Right.
A lot of people get into Twitter and that becomes their primary focus. I personally would say that you'd want to build your own space to direct people to, and treat Twitter, Facebook as kind of an outpost, a satellite around your blog.
Are social media sites like Twitter and Facebook making blogs obsolete, or are they actually increasing the demand for blogs and blog content?
Yeah, I mean, the thing about Twitter is you've got 140 characters.
Right.
If you want to say anything more than 140 characters, you really need to link to something.
Right.
Whether it be YouTube, where you do a video, whether it be a blog where you write a more extended version. I personally see Twitter is my second or third highest referrer of traffic these days to my blogs,
right?
Depending on the blog. So it's a great source of traffic. One of the things that is prevalent on Twitter is people are sharing links. Right. That's what people are using it for. So if you've got a link, content, then it's a great place.